Hello students, whether you have done better than expected in your first exam or maybe things didn't go as planned, this message is for you. Exams are a journey and not a destination. Let's talk about how to stay motivated, learn from our experiences and keep moving forward. Take a moment to think about how you felt after your first exam. Did it go well? Or maybe it didn't. Either way, the most important thing is that what we do next. First, if you didn't do as well as you hoped, don't worry. One exam doesn't define your ability or potential. It's okay to feel disappointed, but what's most important is to pick yourself up and keep going. So this is for you to understand that the most important thing to do right now is to stop overthinking about the exam that didn't go well. What's done is done, and you cannot change the result. Instead of worrying about what went wrong, now we can start focusing on the exams that are still ahead of us. So students, think back to your exam. Were there any certain questions or certain topics that caught you off guard? Maybe you struggled with time management, or maybe you just in panic during the exam. Write these issues down. And parents, based on these challenges that your child faced, you can build a fresh study plan together. By working together, students will feel more supported. And parents, you can also offer guidance on organizing study time effectively. Parents, help your child to set realistic daily goals like completing one chapter or maybe solving a set of questions each day. Celebrate small wins together, as this will keep the child motivated and confident for the next time. So these are certain things to remember for your next exams. First, go through the syllabus for each subject and identify the key topics that carry the most weight. Start by focusing on these first. Make sure you have covered the basics before diving into the more complex details. Second, if time management was the problem in your previous exam, now's the time to fix it. Practice doing 9 question papers at home to improve your speed and accuracy. Break your study sessions like 50 minutes studying and 10 minutes break followed by it. Third, one of the most important ways to prepare is to simulate the exam environment at home. Set a timer, sit in a quiet place and solve questions just like you would do in your exam. This helps you get used to the pressure and avoid zoning out or blanking out during the real exam. Last and not the least, stay physically and mentally healthy. Remember, exams aren't just about studying non-stop. Make sure you're getting enough sleep, you're eating healthy and taking short breaks. A clear and rested mind performs better than an overworked one. Remember, it's okay if things didn't go as planned. What matters now is how you bounce back. Let me share a quote with you that might inspire you. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. So don't give up. You have learned something from this experience and you are stronger for the next exam. If your last exam went well, congratulations. But remember, exams aren't over yet. It's important to keep up the hard work and not get too relaxed. While it's great to feel confident after doing well, it's essential to stay committed to your studying routine. Keep up the good work that got you here. Consistent studying, practicing, and reviewing. While you're feeling good about the last exam, take a moment to review your overall progress. Are there any topics or subjects you're still not comfortable with? Spend extra time on these areas to make sure you're fully prepared. Last, one of the best ways to reinforce what you have learned is by helping others. If you know someone who is struggling with a subject you are strong in, offer to help them. Teaching a topic helps you understand it even better and keeps you grounded as well. Parents, encourage your child to continue with their positive habits while reminding them that each exam is a new challenge. Help them set goals for the remaining exams and praise their efforts as much as their results. Students, remember, each exam is a new opportunity. If one didn't go well, don't lose heart. Learn from it and use it to come back even stronger. If you did well, stay focused and grounded. Keep preparing and give your best in each and every subject. Parents, your support during this time is invaluable. Whether your child is bouncing back from a tough exam or maintaining their success, creating a positive environment and encouraging environment for them is really, really important. Together, we can help them succeed.